struck me because I've never had this kind of initiative in all my going for us conventions and delves, etc. First of all, of course, the job of a parliamentarian is to introduce laws. And we have this summit, parliamentarians from 5 different countries in Africa, led by Kenya. Since Kenya is the first African parliament to introduce the DRC bill, and I believe Nigeria will be second. Challenge to my colleagues here today. Thank you very much. The parliamentarian attracts a lot of publicity whenever he or she is introducing a bill. And I believe introducing this DRC bill will definitely attract the publicity that this initiative needs. And I'm already trying to prepare how to introduce this bill in Nigeria. Nigeria is a very peculiar country. First of all, we have a population of close to 180 million people. And we have like 50% Christians, 50% Muslims. And the first point of call of any infertile patient, in most cases, it's always the church or maybe the mosque. They approach the reverend father or the priest because they believe that the problem of infertility is more spiritual than physical. So our first group of people to educate on infertility would be the priest and also the imams in the mosque, because they are the ones to first of all tell the patients that they are just messengers of God, to tell the patients that God created the doctors and God gave the doctors the wisdom and the knowledge to be able to go into their system to know where the problem is physically. So which is a major agenda in this program to have a culture shift. Also, the parliamentarians in the country, they have a very big role to play because we are the ones that campaign all over the country asking for their votes, and we also have a very good opportunity to educate them. So I intend to educate my colleagues as an ambassador to me of this program to ensure that in all our campaigns around the country, when we campaign, having our town hall meetings, we also have at least two or three sentences to say about the culture shift and also to propagate the mother. I believe this education is coming at the best time, because in Nigeria today, when you go to one of the churches, because Nigeria has the largest churches in Africa, we have some churches that are that is populated by about maybe 2 million people in one service. It's in the Guinness Book of Records that we have the biggest churches. So, during those services, the pastor will ask for couples that are looking for the fruit of the womb. They should come forward. And because different types of problems, people that have problems with their visas, people that have problems with the school fees of their children. But in all these calls, it's the largest people that come out, number of people that come out are people with a problem with the fruit of the womb, which shows that it's a big problem in Nigeria. And in the peculiar situation here is like we have been saying since that it's only the woman that comes up, the man doesn't come up when this problem arises. But in the churches, you see the couples coming out together whenever they are called for this problem for prayers. So that is also an area where we are going to emphasize that it's the husband and the wife that should seek treatment for this infertility. In closing, I'm assuring Merck that I will do everything in my power to ensure that we make the loudest noise in Africa for more.